pretty amazing what you can see in your backyard. You know, if you kind of scan the skies and check the trees, as we're all getting a chance to do with the pandemic keeping us close to home, you will see a lot more than you imagine. Hi, my name's Jeff Wells. I'm the Vice President of Boreal Conservation for the National Audubon Society. And I'm birding today in my backyard, hoping to see a white-throated sparrow. And right now, that sort of sea of white-throated sparrows is moving north, starting to arrive in these northern states like Maine and into southern Canada. And they'll be starting to kind of seep their way up into the boreal in the coming weeks. The boreal forests of Canada are absolutely critical to the survival of songbird species like the white-throated sparrow. The boreal forest serves as the nesting grounds for over 300 bird species that migrate across North America. Over 80% of the world's white-throated sparrows breed in the boreal forest of Canada. It's in these bushes where the white-throated sparrows like to hang out. They love to be down in the shrubby, brushy spots of yards or parks or anything like that during the winter, and in migration, gives them some cover from predators. If you see one, you'll see a bird with a bold white throat, black and white, or sometimes tan and white stripes on the head. It's a little bird, but bigger than a chickadee, which is a bird a lot of people know. We've been getting white-throated sparrows arriving kind of each day, come down in the morning, and we'll hear that "Oh sweet Canada, Canada, Canada" song. It sounds like that's why conserving large areas of the boreal forest is so important, so we can continue to hear the song of the white-throated sparrow in backyards across North America during migration.